Hi guys, I hope all of you are doing well. Here in this video, we are analyzing the problem of Latimer diagram, and we know that Latimer diagrams are very, very important for GATE and JAM chemistry examinations. The question is taken from 2018 GATE chemistry, and watch the video completely to get detailed conceptual analysis of the problem. Okay, the Latimer diagram of oxygen is given below. The value of X is, so just look at the given Latimer diagram. The conversion of molecule or oxygen to water molecule, which is involving two steps here. The conversion of O2 to H2O2 involving standard reduction potential of plus 0.70 volts and H2O2 to H2O involving standard reduction potential of plus 1.76 volts. Now we need to find the value of standard reduction potential for the complete conversion of O2 to H2O. Okay, right here we have an equation for this problem to find the answer in within seconds. That is simply EXY, or standard reduction potential of XY equals to NX into standard reduction potential of EX plus NY into EY0 by NX plus NY. Here N indicating number of electrons involved in that reaction. Okay, now just try to check the first step of conversion of O2 to H2O2. Okay, so where oxygen with, that means simply neutral charge, whereas in H2O2 each oxygen with minus one involving two electrons here. Okay, by taking two electrons, O2 is converting H2O2 here. Okay, by that reduction. In the second step also, you can see two electrons are involving for the conversion of H2O2 to H2O. It may be oxidation or reduction, right? Now, from the conversion, that means the total conversion of O2 to H2O involving four electrons, right? Now, just substitute the values here. NX, that means conversion of O2 to H2O2, two electrons, into EX0, that is the O2 to H2O2 conversion, which is having the standard reduction potential 0.70 plus, now here in the second step of conversion, 2 into the value of E0, 1.76 by 2 plus 2. You can get the value 1.23 as answer. Okay, right here, the question, why we are not going to take some of these two, okay, some of these two standard reduction potentials of two steps, okay, to find the total standard reduction potential for the complete conversion of O2 to H2O. It is one question. And here, second question, why not we take the averages of standard reduction potentials of two steps directly, right? So here, the answer is E, that is reduction potential, or here just take E0, standard reduction potential is a path dependent term. Okay, so just take X, right? By taking two electrons, produces X minus 2. By losing two electrons, produces X plus 2, right? And these two step of reactions, you can see two standard reduction potentials with different signs. Okay, so E0 is a path dependent, right? So we need to convert the path dependent E0 into path independent G, that is free energy. Okay, so G is path independent term. Now, so we know that G equals to minus NFE. So just take G0, NFE0. Okay, so this is the form we need to use here for this problem of water Latimer diagram. Okay, right. Now, just take G0 for the conversion of O2 to H2O should be the sum of these two conversions. Okay, that means the free energies of these two conversions. Now, so G0 of conversion of O2 to H2O2 plus G0 of conversion of H2O2 to H2O. Right, now just substitute G0 value, that is minus NFE0 of O2 to H2O conversion. Now minus NFE0 of O2 to H2O2 conversion.
plus minus NFe0, okay, of H2O2 to H2O conversion. Right, now we can take the value of N here. The complete conversion from O2 to H2O involving 4 electrons, right? So that's why here I can take 4, just cancel minus, right? And F Faraday here, right? Now we have 4E0 for the conversion of O2 to H2O equals to here, just say what is the conversion, that means number of electrons involved here in O2 to H2O2, 2 electrons. So 2E0 O2 to H2O2 plus here the conversion of H2O2 to H2O, 2 electrons are involving, right? So 2E0 H2O2 to H2O. Now 2, 2, and here 2, we can get 2. Now E0, the standard action potential from O2 to H2O complete conversion should be equals to E0 of O2 to H2O2 plus E0 of H2O2 H2O by 2. Okay, now you can get the value 1.23. That is our answer, right? So in many cases, so we need to use the simple equation. You need not to do all of these things. By just doing that, you can solve it. Okay, if you want concept, just look at it. Thank you very much. And if you are interested, just visit and join chemmasters.online for the best concept oriented online courses.